Let's move into meditation here. I'm going to do this meditation by moving through the first four of actually 16 steps in the Buddha's mindfulness of breathing meditation, the Anapanasati Sutta. And then after we've explored those first four steps, I'll bring in a suggestion of my own as a bit of a bonus for you to explore. So let's begin. Finding a posture that is comfortable and alert, in which you take your place. Let yourself arrive in wherever you are physically, and whenever you are in the present. Helping yourself settle in. With your eyes open or closed, it can be nice to have a posture of dignity and self-respect that is relaxed and open-hearted. In this practice, I will offer some suggestions, but I will try to speak as little as possible. You're welcome to turn off the volume on your speakers if you prefer to meditate in silence. And always adapt my suggestions to whatever is useful for you. So let's explore four suggestions that have come to us today from 2,500 years ago, from the Buddha, encouraging mindfulness of breathing. And if there's anything uncomfortable for you about paying attention to the breath, it's okay to apply my suggestions to something else that's an object of awareness, such as your body in general, or a nurturing feeling, a comfortable feeling, such as compassion or gratitude or love, or just simply a growing sense of calm and ease. Here we go. In the first suggestion, be aware of simply breathing. In other words, remain aware of the feeling of breathing. You can focus on different parts of your body, such as your chest, or the upper lip, or your belly, or you can have a sense of your body as a whole as you breathe. First suggestion, remain aware and increasingly absorbed in the sensations of breathing. Stay in touch with the feeling of breathing. It's normal and fine if thoughts, emotions, desires pass through the sky of mind, like flocks of birds or clouds passing by, as you rest primarily in the sensations of breathing. In the second suggestion from the Buddha, be aware of nuances in the experience of breathing. For example, breathing in, know that you are breathing in. Breathing out, know that you are breathing out. Breathing long, know that you are breathing long. Breathing short, know that you are breathing short. Be continuously aware of every single breath. In the third suggestion, be mindful of what's called the whole body of breath. A way to understand that is to be aware of your body as a whole as you breathe. You might start with a smaller area, like your chest as a whole, including many sensations within it as a single experience, and then gradually include more and more of your body, wider and wider, receiving a sense of the whole body continuously as you breathe. Mindful of the whole body of breath. Being aware of sensations throughout your body related to breathing, in your shoulders and neck and head, your hips, including in awareness, your hands and feet, internal sensations of the air coming in, external sensations of the breath around your nose. All of it as a single whole, a single unified experience of breathing, abiding as a whole body breathing. In the fourth suggestion, as it is commonly translated, tranquilizing the body, not making it sleepy, rather relaxing, calming, letting go of tension in the body, letting go of things that disturb the tranquility of the body, things such as anxiety or planning or things you're irritated about. Letting go of these to make room for a warm tranquility spreading throughout your whole body. Perhaps with related qualities of stillness and calm. Remaining aware of the breath as the body becomes more tranquil. The breath naturally becoming softer and lighter. as your body becomes more tranquil, your mind can become quieter and tranquil as well. If you like to stay with the four suggestions of the Buddha, that's fine. And also, if you like, you might want to explore this suggestion from me that builds on this practice. As you abide here, tranquil, you might have a sense of being present like space. Being spacious, open, and you can find a stability in this spaciousness. The spaciousness of mind, the spaciousness of awareness is ongoing. Thus, it is still. There is always this spaciousness of mind. The spaciousness of mind is unmoving. Thoughts and sensations move through it. And as we abide as this spaciousness, there is an inherent stillness in this abiding. experiences pass through the stillness of your abiding. And in our final minutes here, in this spaciousness, if you like, let us include others who are suffering. Let us find compassion and concern for those who are upset, for those in pain, for those who are outraged by injustice. For those who've lost their homes to fire, for those who must bear the weight of systematic, structural forms of mistreatment and injustice. A spaciousness in which there is tenderness and love.